สวัสดีทุกคนนะคะ
I think you're ready
ก็ทุกคน
น่าจะว่าแบบ
พร้อมที่จะสรรเสริญพระเจ้ากันแล้วใช่ไหม
Heavenly God, start by praying. So why don't you reach out in faith right now?
เราจะอธิษฐานด้วยกันนะคะขอยกมือขึ้น
Father, we thank you that you are here.
พระบิดาเราขอบคุณที่พระองค์ทรงอยู่ที่น
ี่ That you are with us.
ที่พระองค์อยู่กับเรา
And Lord, we just open up our hearts to you today.
พระเจ้าเราขอเปิดใจของเราให้พระองค์ว
ัน
น
ี้ We give you honor and glory in this
place.
This is your house.
นี่เป็นบ้านของพระองค์
We worship you.
เรานมัสการพระองค
์ In Jesus name.
ในพระนามพระเยซู
Amen. Come on, why don't we reach out? We love you, Lord. We worship you, Jesus.Sing Spirit of the Living God. Spirit of the Living God. Spirit of the Living God. We only want to hear your voice hanging on every word. Spirit of the Living God. Spirit of the Living God. We want to knowHanging on every word, 'cause when you speak, when you move, when you do what only you can do, it changes us. It changes what we see and what we see. When you come in the room, when you do what only you can do, it changes us. It changes what we see.What we see. Sing it again, Spirit of the Living God. Spirit of the Living God. Spirit of the Living God. Waiting it into all you are. Everything else can.The living God, come now and breathe upon our hearts. Come now and have your way. 'Cause when you speak, when you move, when you do what only you can do, it changes us. It changes what we see and what we see. When you come in the room, when you do what onlyIt changes us, it changes what we see and what we see. Oh, oh, you're changing us, Lord. You're changing us, Lord. Oh, when you move all our fears. Oh, when you'Cause we're living God, Spirit of the living God, welling into all you are. Everything else can wait. Everything else fades away. Your presence, เป็นแสงในชีวิตข้าและข้ายืนมั่นคงในพระองค์หมดชีวิตข้าจะเดินตามเพียงพระองค์ทั้งหมดหัวใจในพระทัยพระบิดาทุกความต้องการทุกลมทุกความต้อง
To Calvary,
where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet. My Savior on that cursed tree. His body bound and drenched in tears, they laid him down in Joseph's tomb, the entrance sealed by heavy stone. Messiah still and all alone.
Come on, this is what we're here to do. Let's praise him.
And all praise the name of the Lord our God. All praise his name forevermore. For endless days we will seek your praise.
Jesus, Jesus.
Come on, let's praise Jesus in this place.
ให้เราสรรเสริญพระองค์ด้วยกันนะคะในที่นี
้ We worship you, God.
เรานมัสการพระองค์พระเจ้า
We thank you, Jesus.
เราขอบคุณพระองค์พระเยซูคริสต
์ We worship you.You know, sometimes we have to tell our soul to praise God.
บางครั้งเนี่ยเราก็ต้องบอกตัวเองนะให้สรรเสริญพระเจ้า
Because if you only praise God when you feel like it,
เพราะว่าถ้าเรามัวแต่สรรเสริญพระเจ้าเฉพาะเวลาที่เรารู้สึกว่าเราอยากสรรเสริญ
You might go a very long time where you struggle to praise God.
แล้วมันก็จะใช้เวลานานเลยกว่าที่เราจะได้สรรเสริญพระองค
์ But David tells himself in the Bible.
แต่เดวิดนะคะบอกเขาบอกตัวเอง
And he says he tells his soul to praise God.
ในพระคัมภีร์บอกไว้ว่าเขาบอกหัวใจจิตวิญญาณของเขาให้สรรเสริญพระเจ้า
Mentally you could be tired, you could have a tough week, or you could be going fantastic.
หัวสมองคุณนะคะคุณอาจจะรู้สึกเหนื่อยล้านะคะหรือว่าคุณอาจจะรู้สึกดีก็ได
้ But whatever place you find yourself coming in today, tell your soul to praise His holy name.
แต่ไม่ว่าคุณจะเข้ามาที่นี่ในสถานการณ์
So come on.
We're
going to do that one more time. We're going to just begin to praise God. So ready? Come on. Let's lift up our voices and praise God.
Come on.
Praise His holy name. Praise His holy name. We worship you. We worship you in this place. We love you. Come on, church. Tell your soul to praise God. Clap your hands. Lift your voice to Him. He is worthy. He is worthy.So Father, we thank you for today.
พระบิดาเราขอบคุณสำหรับวันนี
้ God, we thank you that this is a day that you have made.
เราขอบคุณที่วันนี้เป็นวันที่พระองค์ทรงสร้าง
And we will rejoice.
และเราจะชื่นชมยินดี
We choose to rejoice.
เราเลือกที่จะชื่นชมยินดี
And be glad in it.
แล้วก็ยินดีในพระองค
์ God, we thank you that when you are here.
เราขอบคุณที่เมื่อพระองค์อยู่ที่นี
่ Anything is possible.
ทุกอย่างเป็นไปได้
People can be healed.
ทุกคนจะได้รับการรักษา
Miracles can take place.
การอัศจรรย์จะเกิดขึ้น
God, you can give us dreams and visions.
พระองค์สามารถมอบความฝันและนิมิตให้กับเรา
God, and in this place today, God, we pray you do amazing things.
และในที่นี้ขอพระองค์ทรงทำสิ่งอัศจรรย
์ You heal the brokenhearted.
ขอทรงรักษาหัวใจที่แตกสลาย
You give us vision for the future.
ขอทรงมอบนิมิตให้เราในอนาคต
God, and in this place, let us be united as we lift up your holy name.
และในที่นี้ขอให้เราเป็นน้ำหนึ่งใจเดียวกันที่เราจะยกชู
We love you, Jesus.
เรารักพระองค์พระเยซู
And everyone said,
ให้ทุกคนพูดว่า
Amen. Come on, let's give Jesus. Come on, 2 p.m. A big, big shout of praise.
รอบบ่ายสองนะคะให้เราตบมือให้พระเยซูด้วยกัน
Amen.
Amen.
Wow, can we give our worship team a big hand as well?
เราขอตบมือให้ทีมนมัสการด้วยนะคะ
Beautiful sense of God's presence.
เราสามารถสัมผัสได้ถึงการทรงสถิตของพระเจ้า
Hey, before you take your seats,
ก่อนที่เราจะนั่งลงนะคะ
I want you to find 3 people.
ก็อยากให้หาคน3คน
And go say hello, make a new friend today.
แล้วก็ไปทักทายนะคะให้เราสร้างเพื่อนใหม่กันในวันนี
้ Awesome. Well, so good to have you. You can take your seats.
ก็ดีใจนะคะที่ทุกคนมาอยู่ที่นี่ขอเชิญนั่งลงได้นะคะ
And you are in for a good day today.
วันนี้นะคะเป็นวันที่พิเศษด้วย
If you don't have a seat yet, you're at the back. Come forward, grab a seat.
ก็ถ้ายังไม่มีที่นั่งนะคะข้างหลังเข้ามานั่งข้างในได้นะคะ
And today is Vision Sunday.
วันนี้นะคะเป็น Vision Sunday หรือวันแห่ง
Who's excited for Vision Sunday?
ใครตื่นเต้นสำหรับ Vision Sunday บ้าง
Can you hear me?
ได้ยินมั้ยคะ
I said who's excited for Vision Sunday?
ใครตื่นเต้นสําหรับ Vision Sunday บ้าง
There we go. The 2 p.m. service is alive and well.
ก็ลูกก็บ่าย2นี่ตื่นกันแล้วใช่ม
ั้ย And this whole month we're going to be talking about vision.
ก็ทั้งเดือนนี้นะคะเราจะมาพูดถึงนิมิตกัน
We got a lot of things to talk about but we're starting this week.
มีหลายเรื่องมากค่ะที่เราจะพูดถึงนะคะเราก็เริ่มอาทิตย์นี้อาทิตย์แรก
And I believe it's going to be every week is going to be incredible.
ผมก็เชื่อว่านะคะทุกๆอาทิตย์เนี่ยก็จะเป็นอาทิตย์ที่อัศจรรย์ไปเลย
But one thing we love to do every time we gather is we always have visitors, friends and family who join us.
ก็สิ่งที่เราชอบทําในทุกๆอาทิตย์นะคะคือเรามีคนที่มาเยี่ยมเยียนเราในทุกๆอาทิตย
์ And if you are visiting with us we want to give you one of our welcome packs. It's just a free gift to sayThank you for being here.
ถ้าคุณมาเยี่ยมเยียนเราวันนี้นะคะเราก็อยากจะให้ของขวัญเล็กๆน้อยๆนะคะ
So if this is your first or second time, can you do me a favor and just give me a quick wave and then you can put your hand down again. Come on, give it up right here. So good to have you.
ก็ยินดีนะคะที่
Come on, church, let's do better than that. Let's give a big cheer.
ให้เราตบมือดังๆด้วยกันนะคะ
Thank you for being with us.
ก็ขอบคุณนะคะที่มาอยู่กับเรา
And I'm so glad to have you. You get a free drink after the service as well.
ก็หลังจากนี้นะคะสามารถไปรับกาแฟฟรีได้ด้วย
Other people in church are going to try to get a free one, but they don't get free.
คนอื่นพยายามมาขอฟรีๆนะแต่เขาไม่สามารถทานฟรีได้
That's just for our first time visitors and guests.
ก็สำหรับคนที่มาเยี่ยมเยียนครั้งแรกหรือครั้งสองครั้งกันนะ
And also if you're watching on YouTube, can we give a big cheer for everyone who's watching on YouTube as well?
ก็เราขอตบมือต้อนรับคนที่ดูเราใน YouTube ด้วยนะคะ
So if you're away for some reason you missed somethingyou're sick you can check out our YouTube channel as well
ฉะนั้นนะคะใครมาที่วันอาทิตย์ไม่ได้นะคะหรือไม่สามารถติดอะไรมาไม่ได้ก็สามารถไปดูที่ YouTube ได
้ Well today we're going to do something a little bit different
วันนี้นะคะเราจะทําอะไรต่างๆไปนิดนึง
We are going to do what we would normally do at the end of the service at the beginning of the service
ก็เราจะทําสิ่งที่เราปกติทําตอนท้ายนะคะมาทําตอนเริ่มต้น
So we're going to worship God in bringing our tithes and offerings
เราจะนมัสการโดยการนําเงินถวายของเรามาให้กับพระเจ้าด้วยก
ัน And I said to the 11 AM service
เราก็พูดไปแล้วรอบเช้านะคะ
I said to the my dreamas a pastor my dream as a pastor
อ๋อก็บอกว่าความฝันของผมในฐานะที่เป็นพาสเตอร์เนี่ย
is it when anyone gets on this stage and says it's time to bring our tithes and our offerings
ก็คือว่ามีคนขึ้นเวทีมาแล้วบอกว่าถึงเวลาเรามาถวายทรัพย์พระเจ้า
everyone would go yay
แล้วทุกคนจะโหร้องยินดี
so it's time to bring our tithes and our offerings
ก็ดีใจมากที่เราจะได้เข้ามาถวายให้พระเจ้าด้วยกัน
Praise God.
ก็สรรเสริญพระเจ้านะ
Because it's an act of worship before God.
เพราะว่ามันเป็นการที่แสดงออกถึงการนมัสการพระเจ้าเหมือนกัน
Act of worship where we honor God.
เป็นการแสดงออกถึงการนมัสการเวลาเราถวายเกียรติพระองค์
We put him first in our lives.
แล้วก็ให้พระองค์เป็นที่1ในชีวิตของเรา
And you can give online. There's the details up there. They're also on our website if you forget that or you don't have those.
ก็สามารถโอนเงินได้นะคะแล้วก็มีรายละเอียดอยู่บนนี้นะคะหรือว่าถ้าดูตรงนี้ไม่ทันเนี่ยสามารถไปเปิดดูเว็บไซต์ได
้ And if you are visiting with us or you're new to church andyou're not used to giving no pressure at all to give
แล้วก็สําหรับคนที่เพิ่งมาเยี่ยมเยียนเรานะคะหรือว่ายังไม่ค่อยเข้าใจเรื่องนี้นะคะก็ไม่มีความกดดันอะไรนะคะไม่ต้องถวายได
้ And also on the way out as you exit there'll be a container one of our ushers will have a container you can give that way as well
แล้วก็ตอนขาออกนะคะทีมงานของเราก็จะถือกล่องถวายสําหรับคนที่ต้องการถวายเป็นเงินสดด้วย
Well we have a lot coming up in the life of our church
แล้วก็มีหลายอย่างนะคะที่จะเกิดขึ้นในคริสตจักรของเรา
And so you check out the screen for church highlights
ก็มาดูจอด้วยกันนะคะ
Revival is what happens when God's kingdom comes and His will is done on earth as it is in heaven. You've been called to not be an observer but an activator of the kingdom of God in your life. We're on the hunt for a move of God. Let's contend for it. Let's believe for it. Let's pursue it. Get time in.What are we doing? We're shaping history.
When God speaks, and together we answer His call, we are strengthened to walk forward without fear, to step into His vision.
Awesome. Put your hands together. It's amazing.
เยี่ยมไปเลยนะคะ
Well, Revival Conference is in August.
ก็ Conference Revival นะคะในเดือนสิงหาคม
And we're going to pray that somehow
ว่ายังไงก็ตาม
เนี่ย We don't know how. We don't know how.
เราไม่รู้เหมือนกันมันจะเกิดขึ้นได้ยังไงนะ
But the borders in Australia would open.
แต่ว่าเราอธิษฐานให้ประเทศออสเตรเลียนั้นเปิดออก
And did you know that last year we had over 20 people from here we went to the conference together in Melbourne.
รู้มั้ยคะว่าปีก่อนนะคะเรามีคนจากที่กรุงเทพเนี่ยไปร่วมงานคอนเฟรนซ์เน
ี่ย 20 คน But here's what I'm going to tell you even if the borders don't open.
แต่บอกเลยว่าถึงแม้ว่าประเทศนั้นจะไม่เปิดเราจะบินไม่ได้
Who knows that God wants to move in every city in every location in every place in the world.
พระเจ้านะคะก็ยังต้องการที่จะ คลื่อนไหวในทุกๆเมืองทุกๆที่ทั่วโลก
So we were going to bring revival conference right here if the borders don't open and we're going to have an incredible time in God right here in Bangkok
ถ้าเราไม่สามารถเดินทางได้เนี่ยเราก็จะนํางานฟื้นฟูเนี่ยมาจัดที่นี่เลย
กัน So position your hearts be ready for that later in the year whatever it looks like we know God wants to meet with his people
ก็ไม่ว่ามันจะเป็นรูปแบบไหนนะคะเราขอให้ทุกคนเตรียมตัวให้พร้อมนะคะเราจะเข้ามาร่วมงานฟื้นฟูด้วยกัน
And as you heard today is Vision Sunday so on your seats you mightn't have realized but you just probably under your bottom right now
ก็อย่างที่รู้นะคะวันนี้เป็น Vision Sunday นะคะแล้วก็ตรงเก้าอี้ที่คุณนั่งเนี่ยก็จะมีเอกสาร
Under your seat maybe is two booklets the reason there's two booklets is one is in English and one is in Thai
เหตุผลที่มีอยู่2ฉบับนะคะคืออันนึงเป็นภาษาอังกฤษอันนึงเป็นภาษาไทย
So take whichever one you would prefer and you can leave the other one there
ก็สามารถหยิบไป1ฉบับได้นะคะแล้วก็ถ้าอีกอันไม่เอาก็วางทิ้งไว
้ And during the service today you can read through that you can check out the culture of the church if you don't know and the vision of the church
แล้วก็สําหรับระหว่างคําเทศคํานี้นะคะสามารถอ่านดูรายละเอียดได
้ And we're going to hear Pastor Corey right now
เดี๋ยวเราจะมาฟังคําเทศจากอาจารย์ Corey ก
ัน Unpack the vision for 2021
เพื่อที่จะอธิบายเกี่ยวกับวิชั่นของเราในปี2021
So why don't you check the screens out what I want you to do as well
ก็ที่อยากให้ทําด้วยเหมือนกันนะคะ
Is when you hear something that you think is awesome
คือถ้าเกิดว่าคุณได้ยินอาจารย์พูดอะไรที่รู้สึกว่ามันเยี่ยมไปเลย
You say this word that you should say in church a lot Amen.
สิ่งที่คุณต้องอันพูดในโบสถ์บ่อยๆเลยก็คือ Amen.
And you can clap.
แล้วคุณสามารถตบมือได
้ Just because Pastor Corey is not in the building doesn't mean we shouldn't agree with what's being said.
การที่อาจารย์ Corey ไม่ได้อยู่ที่นี่ตัวเป็นๆเนี่ยไม่ได้หมายความว่าเราไม่ต้องไม่เห็นด้วยกับเขาได้
So come on, let's get our notebooks out, our phones out. Let's receive this vision for 2021.
ให้เรามารับนิมิตปี2021ด้วยกันนะคะ
So check out the screen.
วิสัยทัศน์ของเราคือการสร้างคริสตจักร200แห่งทั่วโลกผ่านศูนย์กลาง4แห่งซึ่งยึดถือจิตวิญญาณของการฟื้นฟูเพื่อสร้างสาวกในทุกชนชาติ
Hello, Numa, Bangkok, and welcome to Vision Sunday. Pastor Corey here. I'm so excited about what God's doing across Numa Church globally right now, particularly what he's doing in Bangkok. And I've got things that God has put upon my heart to share with you. Let's pray, and we're going to get into this Vision Sunday message. Father, I thank you today for the power of your Holy Spirit to speak and inspire to reveal your thought, your will, your intention for our lives and for our church. I pray, God, your blessing upon this word, quicken to my mind and my heart those things that you have scripted upon my heart. I pray, Father, that, Lord, today this would be a blessing, an encouragement, affirmation, but also, Lord, it would catapult Numa Bangkok and all of Numa Church Global into the destiny, into the purpose and future that you have called us to. And Holy Spirit, you are the author. You are the inspirer of visions and dreams. And I ask, oh God, right now that you would give us ears to hear what your Spirit is saying and doing, but also eyes to see, that our hearts would connect and engage with your word, your vision for Numa Church, I pray in Jesus' name. Amen.I want to encourage you to go with me to Acts chapter 16, verses 6 to 10. I'm going to read a few verses about the Macedonian call and the Apostle Paul's encounter with vision and with the Spirit of God that really led him on a journey towards what God wanted him to do. I believe it's relevant for us as Numa Church today. The Bible says, Acts chapter 16, verse 6, and they went.That is, Paul, Silas, and Timothy went through the region of Phrygia and Galatia, having been forbidden by the Holy Spirit to speak the word in Asia. And when they had come up to Mysia, they attempted to go into Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus did not allow them. So passing by Mysia, they went down to Troas. And a vision appeared to Paul in the night. A man of Macedonia was standing there urging him and saying, come over to Macedonia and help us. And when Paul had seen the vision, immediately we sought to go on into Macedonia, concluding that God had called us to preach the gospel to them. I want to tell you a story about a young man by the name of Patrick. Patrick grew up living a privileged life of aristocracy in Roman Britain. And Patrick's father was a magistrate. And in the future, Patrick would in fact inherit the role and his father's estate because Patrick's family was in fact a part of Roman nobility. Everything changed in the 5th century. In 405 AD, Irish raiders seized Patrick and sold him into slavery to barbarians for 6 long years. Living in isolation, hunger and cold, in fact, brought misery to Patrick, but it also brought humility to Patrick in as it concerns to his relationship towards God. Over time, though nothing had changed externally, God, in fact, transformed Patrick's heart from slave to son. Patrick began to understand what it meant for him to become a child of God. And one night, whilst in slavery, God spoke to Patrick in a dream about a ship that was waiting to take him home to his family. And so 200 miles later, Patrick escaped the slavery of the 6 years that he had been facing, and he boarded a ship back home to his family. After normal life had resumed, Patrick woke up one night to the voices of people in Ireland crying out, begging him to come back and help them and preach the gospel to them. Patrick's plans for his life immediately changed. And he answered God's call to go back and minister to the very barbarians and people that had kept him captive in slavery all of these years before. By the time of his death, literally hundreds of monasteries, churches and schools had been established with over thousands, literally thousands of ministers being trained and sent out to the mission field. And to this day, St. Patrick's Day is celebrated around the world in memory of his life and legacy. You see, St. Patrick's life actually runs parallel with the Apostle Paul's experience and often our experience, where our plans for our future aren't always God's vision for our lives. Acts 16 tells us that Timothy, Paul and Silas were traveling northwest from Antioch, and they were traveling through city after city, and common sense would tell you that they should be preaching the gospel in each city that they go through. And yet, the Bible tells us that the Holy Spirit leads them on a 644-kilometer journey by foot to Troas to receive God's vision for their life. Literally, God shut every door of ministry along that entire journey so that they would encounter and pursue God's vision for their lives. I remember as an adolescent trying to train for years to sort of birth my athletic career and trying to secure a contract with local corporate sponsors to help me pursue my dreams of being a professional athlete. I trained 3 to 5 hours a day. I had coaches. I was competing. And yet it seemed like no matter how hard I tried, the doors to sponsorship just wouldn't open. And I found myself one time getting to an all-time low where I received a letter from the Puma company with a hat and a t-shirt, sort of, you know, like a little gift to sort of encourage me. And I'm just thinking to myself, what am I doing? Nothing seems to be working in all that I'm doing. Meanwhile, for years, God was speaking to me and calling me to go and preach the gospel and to accept invitations. People were inviting me to go and speak all over the place. And I'd always knock them back thinking, no, I didn't want to do that with my life. And yet the very first time that I preached the word of God to a church, They blessed me with a love offering and an honorarium. And the very first time, I tried for years to break through into athletics, but the first time I opened up my mouth and preached the gospel and aligned with the open door that God had for me, God began to bless me in a significant way. Not every door that's closed to you in life is the devil. Sometimes God closes one door because he has a better idea, a better vision, a better calling in mind for you that he wants you to pursue. My life plan did not include preaching the gospel, planting a church, being itinerant to the wider body of Christ. It certainly didn't include leading Pneuma Church. And yet all of those things that I thought I didn't want to do were in fact the very things that God had a vision for my life and ended up becoming the greatest blessing of my life. Proverbs 16:9 says, "The heart of man plans his way, but the Lord orders his steps." How do we connect to and see God's vision for our lives? God's vision is conceived through a supernatural encounter with God. The Bible tells us further in verses 8 and 9, "So passing by Mysia, they went down to Troas, and a vision appeared to Paul in the night. This vision was of a man of Macedonia standing there urging him and saying, 'Come over to Macedonia and help us.'" You see, out of the overflow of Paul's relationship with God, out of the overflow of his intimacy with the Holy Spirit, a creative transfer took place from the Holy Spirit to Paul's spirit, and he began to see what God sees for his life and his ministry. There was a literal visible image that appeared to his spiritual sight of a man from Macedonia asking for Paul and his team to go across and help him. And the Bible records right throughout Scripture from Genesis to Revelation that God would often communicate his intentions to people through visions and dreams, and particularly in the night hours. The Bible tells us in Genesis that God spoke to the patriarchal figure of Jacob, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. In fact, God spoke to Abraham in the night about counting the stars in the sky. God spoke to Jacob when he was in the promised land at night as he rested on this stone, and he had a vision of angels ascending and descending from this ladder from heaven. He woke up and he said, "This is none other than the house of God and the very gate of heaven." We see in the New Testament that God spoke to Joseph. Mary and Joseph were betrothed to each other. Mary was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Joseph, wanting to divorce her quietly and being a just and devout man, interpreting and thinking that something had happened outside of their relationship, that Mary had gone off and violated this commitment and covenant that she had made to Joseph to be married. He wanted to divorce her quietly, but it was in the middle of the night that God gave Joseph a dream and explained what was happening, and that he was actually entrusted with the responsibility to care for Mary and to raise Jesus up in a healthy, safe, and strong family. The Bible tells us in Job 33 verse 14, "For God speaks in a dream, in a vision of the night, when deep sleep falls on men, while they slumber on their beds. Then he opens the ears of men, concealing pride from him." Job is talking about what happens when God comes and often speaks to us in the night hours, speaks to us through dreams and visions, communicates his intentions. Why does he often come at night and do that? It's so our flesh would not take the glory for what God reveals to us. Often when we are physically at rest and asleep, our spirits are still awake and alive, and God can speak to our spirit without the interruption of the distractions of our physical flesh. You need to know visions and dreams are the language of the Holy Spirit to communicate to you God's purpose and intention for your life. When God appoints a leader to a ministry or to a church, he anoints them with a vision to fulfill. The Bible says in verse 10 of this passage, when Paul had seen the vision. The Bible doesn't say that when the team had seen it. They said when Paul, the apostle, had seen the vision. In the Bible, when God wanted to get something done, He would call an individual and He would reveal to them His plans, His purposes, His intentions, not just for them, but for God's people. When God wanted to start His family on earth again after the defilement of the fallenness of humanity, Genesis 3 and the Tower of Babel and Genesis 11, when God wanted to start again, He actually called Noah and He asked Noah to build a boat and to preserve a remnant to start the human race again. When God wanted to deliver His people from Egypt, He spoke to Moses. When God wanted to start His chosen people on the face of the planet, He went to Abraham and He called Abraham. When God wanted the gospel to go to the Gentiles, He gave Peter a vision. When God wanted the church to be established in good doctrine, He gave a vision and He gave insight and revelation through the spirit of wisdom and revelation to the Apostle Paul. The Apostle Paul said to King Agrippa when he was standing in front of him, "I was not disobedient to the heavenly vision." Vision is never the byproduct of groupthink, but it's a byproduct of a leader's encounter with God. And when God called us to lead Pneuma Church globally, He gave us a vision to fulfill, not simply a past to repeat. God always prepares a person before He builds a ministry. Vision never just happens in a vacuum. It never just comes from nowhere. It always comes from the Spirit of God, putting the seeds of that vision into someone's heart and life. And just as Nehemiah told the remnant in Jerusalem of the hand of God that had been upon him for good, I want to share with you some of the encounters that I have had and my wife have had along the journey where God has spoken to us and given us visions and dreams for Pneuma Church and its future. In fact, it was back in 2005 when I was a youth and young adult pastor at Care Force Church, serving under the ministry of Dr. Allen and Helen Meyer, where I was in a prayer meeting one night. And during prayer, one of the elders of the church, one of the great men of the church, came up to me and was speaking to me and praying for me. And God, just before he came up, had said, "You know what, son, what is it that you want from me?" Now, whenever God comes to you and says, "What do you want from me?" you better think about that question and what your answer is going to be. Throughout the Bible, God came to different people. He came to Solomon. "What do you want?" He said to Solomon. You better think about that question before you answer it. And when this man of God came up to me and laid hands and began to pray, he said, he confirmed the word and he said, "God's coming to you and asking, what do you want?" And as I began to pray and intercede and pour out my heart to God of some of the desires that He placed there, I began to see a picture, almost an elevated view of planet Earth. And I began to see almost like it was fireballs catapulting out from the city of Melbourne. And they were going to strategic cities all around the world. And when they would hit that city, that fireball would cascade out and ripple out right across that city. And part of that vision was reflected in that which I'd asked of the Lord. In 2018, on a plane trip to Perth, when we knew that we were stepping into the role of being the senior leaders of Pneuma Church, as I'm on the plane about 45 minutes into the flight, the Holy Spirit speaks to me and says, "I want you to plant a church in every state capital city across Australia." I was just transfixed in that moment with what I just heard. And I began to imagine and see Pneuma churches being planted in every state, capital, city, and territory. Also in 2018, when I was preaching at a conference at Inspire Church in Liverpool in Sydney, I just ministered and prophesied over people. I stepped back from the platform, was standing off to the side of the platform, watching about 1,000 youth and young adults at this conference. And as I'm standing there, this screen almost appeared in front of me, and I began to see each of our kingdom culture values one after the other, beginning to scroll down in front of me. And as each scrolled down, God prompted me with a scripture verse to complement each of those values. Prayer fuels power. God's word is our foundation. Love gives generously. Miracles are normal. Church is a covenant family. Freedom is a responsibility. Making disciples is not optional. All of these things, God began to scroll down and a verse corresponding to that value. That was birthed out of an encounter. When we came into the role, Pastor Phil actually prayed over me. Pastor Phil, as some of you would not know, but previously, many years ago, used to lead the church and now is an elder in the church. And when he prayed over me and at his house, I went out in the spirit, and for about 15, 20 minutes, God began to show me visions and pictures and ideas of what he had for the future. And within that encounter, the Holy Spirit said, I want you to rename the church Pneuma Church. I'd never heard of a church by the name of Pneuma Church before. And in fact, I knew it was the Holy Spirit because I never would have chosen that. In fact, my immediate reaction was, I don't necessarily like that name. And I'm like, no, let's just put that on the back burner. Don't tell anybody about that. Maybe that was just bad pizza the night before. But I knew that God had spoken to me. And now we've gone on a journey of, with the blessing of leadership and eldership, renaming the church Pneuma Church. In early 2019, at our first executive team retreat, just after we'd taken on the church, we had 2 hours of prayer and prophecy. And in that encounter, God began to speak to me, show me pictures of the Arc de Triomphe in Paris and the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. And it would just lingered and lingered. It wouldn't leave me. And then God spoke to me and said, I want you to go and I want you to plant a church in those cities. And then the idea of the four hubs, Melbourne, Bangkok, Paris and San Francisco, began to emerge as we began to see God's heart intention for our future. At Margaret Court Arena in 2019, I was standing there watching all of the youth and young adults come for a big Youth Alive event. And as I'm watching there, the stadium is filling up. And the Holy Spirit speaks to me as I'm there in the up in the tiered seating, watching all of the young people go into the stadium. And the Lord said to me, what if what I asked you to do didn't fill stadiums? And I thought to myself, that's a rather bizarre question. What do you mean? Of course we want to fill stadiums. We want to fill the MCG, for goodness sake. We want to fill every stadium, see heaps of people come to know the Lord. He said, what if what I asked you to do wasn't to fill stadiums, but in fact was to plant churches that transform nations all over the earth? Would you be okay with that? I thought this is a rather bizarre conversation, but I gave it great thought. 10 minutes went by, 15 minutes. Oh, again, I wanted to be careful about how I answered that. And I said, God, if that is your heart for us, if that is what you want us to do, we will align with that accordingly. We will plant churches that we believe your anointing will be on to transform nations. And I believe that all of these encounters have not occurred by accident, but Holy Spirit intention, because what God has birthed for us 95 years ago, he's now calling us to build upon for the future. Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 2 says, write the vision, make it plain on tablets so he may run who reads it. For still the vision awaits its appointed time. It hastens to the end. It will not lie. If it seems slow, wait for it. It will surely come. It will not delay. It was in that moment as I'm standing there at that stadium and I said, God, if that's what you want us to do, that's what we'll do. And in a flash, in that moment, God said to me, good, because there's 200 churches in you that I've called you to plant as Pneuma Church. I really believe as we've submitted this vision and these encounters to our executive team and we've fleshed it out and worked it through, that God's vision for us as we move forward into 2021 and beyond is to plant 200 churches across 4 global hubs that carry a spirit of revival to disciple cities and nations. Over the last 95 years, some of you wouldn't know, but approximately 150 churches have been planted directly or indirectly through the influence of Pneuma Church. In 2019, at our closer conference, Pastor Russell Evans prophesied a multiplication anointing upon Pneuma. He prophesied at the conference what took 10 years would take 1 year. And what was done in 50 years would take 5 years. Historically, church planting has been the most effective strategy for fulfilling the Great Commission and remains so to this day. Jesus has anointed his church to be the vehicle that advances the kingdom of God across the earth. And personally, I'm very reluctant to attach numbers to vision. But where God directs specifically, I believe we must align with accordingly in faith. 200 churches across 4 global hubs wasn't conceived in a test tube of clinical conversation, but in fact was conceived and birthed out of an encounter with the Holy Spirit of God. As Pneuma Church was birthed in revival, God is calling us to carry that same spirit of revival everywhere we plant a church. The mandate of the Great Commission isn't just to disciple our next door neighbor, but where that begins with our next door neighbor, it must move to in churches discipling cities and nations. In 2019, Prophet David McCracken prophesied that God was preparing us for conquest of cities and of nations. And he shared with us a picture of like a huge sail being added to an ocean yacht, and that we were to catch the wind of the Spirit and go where God was wanting us to go. I believe it's time to set our sail to the wind of the Spirit, to go where God is sending us. And we are so excited that just as last year we cast vision for starting Pneuma Church in Perth, and there will be an official launch of that just after Easter. And we're so excited about what is already happening in Pneuma Perth with Pastors Jason and Olivia Staggers. We also talked about and cast vision for a new facility for our East location. Well, so too in 2021, we are stepping into new territory. We are so excited to announce that the next city across Australia that God has called us to go and plant a church in is the city of Hobart in Tasmania. Pneuma Hobart is coming to the state of Tasmania. I was in prayer one day. I had another city on my mind. I was praying about it. And God spoke to me and said, "No, son, it's time for you to plant in Hobart. It's time. Hobart is on my calendar. And I am wanting to establish a new ministries and new works in that city and in that state." At the same time as that, our own prophet, Stacey Hillier, was at the beach with her family, along with our family, and she saw the Spirit of Tasmania leave the dock at the port of Melbourne and beginning to head out to the bay. And Holy Spirit spoke to her, and we hadn't conversed before this conversation. And the Holy Spirit said, "It's time to take the Pneuma into Tasmania, the Spirit of Tasmania." The word Pneuma means spirit, wind, and breath. We really believe that Hobart is on God's calendar. God loves Hobart. God loves Tasmania. And the church in Tasmania is doing so many great things. But God's called us to partner with the body of Christ and to complement what he's doing by establishing and planting Pneuma Hobart. We're so excited that after prayer, deliberation, and process, and lots of conversations, we're able to confirm, and we want to announce today that Pastors Joel and Bree Krigsman, who have been our kids' pastor, they're actually going to become our new Hobart location pastor. So wherever you are right now, why don't you just put your hands together and honor, because I'm going to ask Pastor Joel just to come up on the platform with me. And we are so excited about all that is about to unfold, not only for Pneuma Hobart, but particularly for Joel and Bree. Joel, why don't you just share with us just some of what is stirring in your heart and what a bit of this journey that has happened over recent days leading to this momentous decision.
Yeah, so we, hello Pneuma Bangkok, we started off really anxious about this, but we've just had such a confirmation of God's call on our lives to move our family from Melbourne to Hobart, and we are so excited as we begin to get to know some of what already God is doing in Hobart. We are so excited by what God is going to continue to do through Pneuma Hobart, but also through the wider body of Christ in that city. And so we're excited, we're like energetic on fire, and we can't wait to get on the ground. And so we just thank you so much much for your prayer. Absolutely. Even though we're physically going, you're coming with us, and so we're pumped.
Absolutely. Why don't we just pray for Pastor Joel and Bree and their beautiful kids. Father, we just thank you so much for calling this family, Lord, to go and establish Pneuma Hobart, oh God, in the state of Tasmania. We pray, Father, that your anointing and grace and favor would be upon them in this preparation season. That, Lord, as they get ready to plant later this year, I pray, Father, that, Lord, resource, oh God, would be, Lord, given to them. Lord, that there would be people that would hear the call, oh God, both in Tassie as well as around Australia to go to Hobart and establish this ministry. We are so excited about what you are about to do. Father, I thank you for Joel's faithfulness in his ministry, his leadership gift, his teaching grace. Lord, the heart that he has to pioneer, plant, and Lord, we're just believing good success over his life, over his ministry, and Bree and the kids as together they go and establish Pneuma Hobart. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Awesome. So we're going to be launching Pneuma Hobart later this year, and we'll give you more details over the coming months. Not only that, but this year we are believing that we will find a facility to fit out for Pneuma West location here in Melbourne. And we're so excited about getting a more permanent address for our Pneuma West location. Pastor Dave and Sonia, the team, doing a phenomenal job. And we really want to come alongside and support them financially and in prayer to see this become a reality. Also, when it comes to Disciple the Nations, in 2021, we are bringing our Disciple the Nations global mission offering into our One Vision offering. It's so important that you understand in Bangkok that Disciple the Nations and what we do with global mission isn't a secondary focus or ministry to our One Vision. It's all a part of the One Vision. And to aid communication purposes, to aid focus, intentionality, and also stewardship of resource, we want to make sure that we align key vision focus to the One Vision offering. And so when we give into this vision offering in a few weeks' time, and you will be a part of that, we're giving sacrificially out of a heart of generosity to see not only Disciple the Nations have everything it needs to keep building towards our global mission partners, but our entire vision for 2021 being supplied generously and abundantly so that God's purposes for his church can be established this year. Pastor Rob and the team, along with Tonya and others, it's a privilege to serve our global mission partners and all that God has called us to. As well as that, Pneuma College is in its second year here in Melbourne. The School of Transformation now has added to it the School of Equipping. We have over 20 students this year in our leadership development pathway. We have over 150 participants now, and we are so excited about what God is doing at Pneuma College. That's part of our vision offering for this year to keep building and supporting it. Revival Conference, August 26 to 28. We understand the dynamics of all of the challenges to do with COVID restrictions potentially could impact aspects of who can come and who can't come. But we are believing that the borders will open, that our guest speakers will come, that a whole swag of people from Pneuma Bangkok will be there. August 26, 28, we're going to see a move of God, the power of the Holy Spirit, and you are going to be a part of that. And we're so excited about that. Our Pneuma Care app that is connected and aligned with our evangelistic ministry is all about increasing our engagement with what God is already doing in our community, increasing our evangelistic awareness and potency for engaging with people that are far away from the Lord. That also is a key. We're launching that this year. We are so excited about it. And then obviously, we're wanting to continue to build into the vision of Pneuma Bangkok and all that God's doing through your facility and your ministry. Committed to continuing to support that as we move into 2021, and also for Pneuma Perth as we officially launch Pneuma Perth just after Easter in April of this year. On top of that, we just wanted to take a moment to plant a seed of vision for late 2022. we have been praying and we've been seeking God about what is in His heart for 2022. And one of the things that God has spoken to us, among several things, is that we are to set our sights to go overseas once again and plant Numa San Francisco. And so that is hot off the press. We just wanted to give you some insight to that. The reason that we are casting vision for that this year and not just waiting till next year is because there's a lot of preparation that has to go into making that a reality. And with all the dynamics of travel restrictions, etc., we need to start now and we need to start seeding that. And so we just want to encourage you to be praying about that and standing with us as we believe that as God sends us into the United States and plants on the west coast of America in San Francisco. Now, if God's vision is going to be fulfilled, what's been entrusted to one, actually God is calling to be stewarded and shared by all. The Bible tells us in verse 10, when Paul had seen the vision, immediately we, Dr. Luke says, who wrote Acts, we sought to go on into Macedonia, concluding that God had called us to preach the gospel to them. Did you notice that? When Paul saw it, the team pursued it. What was entrusted to one needed to be owned and shared and stewarded by all. No leader receives a vision from God to serve themselves. The leader is a steward of the vision that God's entrusted for the sake and benefit of the church and the people. God never intended the church to be a spectator sport. But in fact, the body of Christ is who we are, where every member of the body is important, significant, necessary, and needed for the vision to become a reality. I heard a funny story of three men who were digging a ditch beside a road, and a pedestrian passed by, went up to the first man digging the ditch and said, "What are you doing?" And he rather casually replied back, "Well, what does it look like? I'm digging a hole in the ground." And then he went up to the next guy, and the next guy said, "Well, I'm doing what I'm told. This is what they gave me a shovel. They told me to dig. I'm doing what I'm told." And then this pedestrian went up to the third guy and said, "What are you doing?" And he said, "I'm actually helping build a skyscraper." You see, all three men were doing the same task, but only one was working with the vision in mind. Can I encourage you? It's not enough just to fulfill the task and the responsibility. We need to not just see the vision, but hear the call to serve with the vision in mind. None of us are serving ourselves. We're serving God's heart for His people and His purposes and intentions for our future. It was just a couple of years ago when Pastor David Storer and Pastor Mark Varughese came and ministered as guest ministries in our church, where they sort of identified in the Spirit that Numa Church was called to be an aircraft carrier for the body of Christ. And it was an interesting affirmation of an analogy that God had spoken to my heart about. I remember being in San Diego and visiting the USS Midway aircraft carrier, which now is turned into an historical museum with a lot of different planes on the tarmac of that ship. And this boat is docked at Navy Pier in San Diego. And as we went on this tour, it took a long time to sort of check this whole thing out because it was huge. And you learn that an aircraft carrier is nuclear powered and it's sent on mission with a battle group of other ships around it. An aircraft carrier employs an army to equip and supply fighter jets to the front line of battle. And I began to think about that as it applies to Numa Church. Numa Church, we are not a luxury cruise liner that simply dispenses Christian goods and services to satisfy customers. A cruise liner will often wander aimlessly and then return back to where it started, dropping people off. But we are not a luxury cruise liner. We are an aircraft carrier that is empowered by the Spirit to advance the kingdom of God across the earth. We are called to equip saints for the work of the ministry and to send them out to the seven mountains of influence, whatever industry or area of work you're in, whether that's in medical and health, whether that's in government or arts and entertainment, sports, education, the family unit, all of these places are mountains of influence that God has called us to. We have been commissioned with a Holy Spirit apostolic mandate to send leaders out to plant churches. And like the Apostle Paul, we will not be disobedient to the heavenly vision. You in Bangkok are a fulfillment of a vision that God has given previous leaders of this church to plant, and that God gave your own pastors, Pastor Jesse and Amanda, who are doing a phenomenal job in the city of Bangkok. We believe that there not only will be one Pneuma church in Asia, but I'm believing and can see many churches right across Asia being planted in years to come as part of this 200 church vision. And so over the next four Sundays, we want you to come every week and partner with what God is speaking to us as a church right now. Next week, we're going to be looking at kingdom culture. The next week after that, we're going to be celebrating Disciple the Nations Sunday. And the next week after that, on March 14th, we're going to be taking up our vision offering, where we are believing that every vision need and every key vision item will be generously and abundantly supplied. That will see that God's house filled to overflowing with all the resource that we need to be able to fulfill what's in God's heart. You are a part of that. And then beyond your giving and beyond your faithfulness with your generosity, can I encourage you, partner with what God is doing in our church. Serve on team. Pray. Disciple. Use your gifts to make a difference in the world around you. And together, we are going to see God's vision not just be seen in a few people's hearts, but become material, become reality right before our very eyes. And we will point to it and say, this is the Lord's doing. And it's marvelous in our eyes. I, in fact, want to encourage you right now. Why don't you stand where you are? I'm just going to ask you to hold all of those things in your hand right now. And you go away over the next coming weeks and you begin to prayerfully consider, what is it that God is asking of you to generously give into our vision offering in a few weeks' time? Why don't we pray together in faith? Father, we stand together in faith today. We thank you, O God, that you've given us a holy vision, a Spirit-inspired vision. And Father, like the Apostle Paul, we will not be disobedient to the heavenly vision. I pray right now that, God, you would open our eyes, open our ears and our hearts to hear and to see and to own what it is that you are leading us towards. Father, I pray that this vision would not remain just an idea, but it would become a tangible reality as all of us, O God, share in it, steward it, and generously sacrifice, O God, towards it. Father, I thank you that this vision will not be fulfilled just on good intentions, but living sacrifices. And Father, I pray for your blessing over every person at Pneuma Bangkok. Thank you for Pastors Jesse and Amanda and the team. Thank you for what you're building. Thank you for what you're doing. And Father, I just pray, oh God, that we would see Pneuma Bangkok continue to grow, explode, and multiply, oh God, in its influence and impact right across the city of Bangkok and right across the continent of Asia. Father, we just thank you today that you are for us and not against us, that we can step out in faith knowing that you go before us, you supply our need, you make a way through. And so, God, we entrust to you, Lord, all that you have given to us. We're not the owners of it, we're the stewards of it. Help us to be faithful stewards, not only of our resource, but over the vision that you've entrusted to Pneuma Church Global. We love you, we honor you, and I commit Pneuma Bangkok into your hands over this Vision Month season and beyond in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Well, I want to thank you so much for listening and for watching this Vision Sunday message. And I just pray God's richest blessings on you as together we move forward to fulfill God's vision for our future. God bless you. See you soon.
Let's put our hands together for Pastor Corey. Hey, just close your eyes just for one moment. And as we heard that message, you know, it's such a big vision. And I think God gives us big vision as a church. Because we know we can't do it in our own strength. But as big as a vision is, God cares about vision and His plan and His purpose for every one of you. He knows you so intimately. And as that message was being preached, I just sensed that God was speaking to individuals. And He's putting vision within you. He's putting dreams and sparking new vision in your spirit. He's putting faith inside of you to begin to see more than you're seeing right now. So just right where you are, why don't you just reach out? I want to pray over you right now. Father, I pray over every person in this room today. God, I pray your Holy Spirit will seal that word in every life. God, I thank you that you are a God that knows the plans you have for us. They're not plans for disaster. They're not plans to harm us. They're plans for a future and a hope. So God, I speak and pray and declare a future and a hope over every individual. God, although you're so big, God, you care so much about every person here, every individual need, God, every person's vision for their own life. God, I pray you would cause them to see what you see. God, and those of us that maybe God is realigning our visions, that God, when a door shuts, we will be open to whatever you have for us. God, we'll be prepared to open our hearts to you and trust your leading, trust your guidance.
And
we give you all the praise and all the honor in Jesus' name. And everyone said, come on, 2 p.m. let's cheer for God. We praise His holy name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Well, what an exciting vision. I want to encourage you, do not miss a single week over the next 3 or 4 weeks. We're going to be unpacking vision and talking more about it. But there's two things, I want you to all stay standing. There's two things I have to tell you before we go. One is this, life groups have just started back. Okay, this is what I need you to do. I'm going to tell you something. If you're not in a life group, you need to be in a life group. Turn to the person next to you. Either way. And say, you need to be in a life group. Turn to the other side. Say, you need to be in a life group. Okay, this is how easy it is. What you need to do is, you know, you have a smartphone in your pocket. All you need to do is this. See this QR code? You point it at that, and automatically every life group comes on your screen on your phone. And so you can't say, I never knew there was a life group. You can't say, no one told me about life groups. Because I just told you. And also, we've made it even easier at our information hub is the QR code. And yesterday, our team put it, even when you sit down on the toilet in our toilets, there's a QR code behind the door.
เวลาคุณนั่งห้องน้ำอยู่เนี่ยข้างหน้าก็มีคิวอาร์โค้ด
True story. You can go try the toilets after.
เรื่องจริงนะคะไปดูในห้องน้ำได้เลย
And as you're sitting on the toilet, you'll see the QR codes.
ก็นั่งในห้องน้ำก็จะเห็น QR นะคะไม่สามารถ
And so I encourage you, not only for you, but also for other people that you can encourage be in a life group.
ก็ไม่ใช่สำหรับคุณเท่านั้นนะคะแต่สามารถคุณสามารถไปหนุนใจคนอื่นให้เข้ามาร่วม life group ได้ด้วย
Second thing, really simple.
อีกสองอีกข้อหนึ่งนะคะ
On the screen right now.
บนจอตอนนี
้ Is our teams.
คือทีม
Dear Lord Jesus, in the name of Yes.
Team, nah.
See, every person in our church can be in a life group.
ก็ทุกคนในโบสถ์ของเรานะคะสามารถเข้าไปร่วมใน life group ได
้ And can be on a team.
และอีกอย่างหนึ่งคือเขาสามารถร่วมมาในทีมอาสาสมัครได
้ Because most people that serve on a team will serve maybe once every 3 weeks.
เพราะว่าหลายคนที่เข้ามาช่วยกันรับใช้ในทีมอาสาสมัครเนี่ยอาจจะทำประมาณครั้งหนึ่งต่อ3อาทิตย์
They might give 1 hour or 2 hours.
ก็ใช้เวลาอาทิตย์ละ 1-2 ชั่วโมง
In a whole 3 weeks, just 2 hours.
ในระยะเวลา3อาทิตย์เนี่ยคุณใช้เวลา2ชั่วโมง
And again, all you need to do is with your smartphone is you just put it on the QR code and every team in our church will just automatically pop up on your phone.
ก็เหมือนเดิมนะคะสามารถสแกน QR code นี้ได้แล้วก็จะมีรายชื่อของทีมขึ้นมาให้
Can I tell you if you give 1 or 2 hours every month and say I can just serve once a month?
แล้วก็บอกเลยนะคะถ้าคุณสามารถบอกว่าเราจะใช้เวลา 1-2 ชั่วโมงในการรับใช
้ People like Nat won't have to be on 17 teams
ก็อย่างแนทเนี่ยก็ไม่ต้องเข้าไปรับใช้ทั้งหมด17ทีม
So if you just say okay I'll help 2 hours a month
ก็ถ้าอย่างคุณถ้าคุณบอกว่าอยากจะช่วย2ชั่วโมงต่อเดือน
The whole church is going to benefit from you serving and using your gifts
คนทั้งคริสตจักรนะคะสามารถที่จะได้ผลประโยชน์จากการที่คุณได้เข้ามาช่วย
Super easy you can do it
มันง่ายมากเลยคุณสามารถ
So join one of our teams we'd love to have you on our team
ก็เข้ามาร่วมทีมของเรานะคะเราก็อยากจะให้คุณเข้ามาช่วยเรา
Hey we're going to leave praising God
เราจะออกไปนะคะแล้วสรรเสริญพระเจ้าไปด้วย
So we started and I love this song praise the name of God or something like that
ก็ชอบเพลงนี้มากเลยนะทั้งการสรรเสริญ
And I don't know what it is about it, but it just stirs something to lift up the name of Jesus.
ก็ไม่รู้ว่าทำไมนะแต่มันรู้สึกว่าเราใจให้เราได้ยกชูพระนามของพระเจ้า
So come on, let's praise God and let's go out praising Him passionately.
ให้เราสรรเสริญพระเจ้านะคะในขณะออกไปที่นี่
Come on, let's sing together our praise and all praise.